Hey everybody, it is your cousin Kevin, and it's the first of the quarter with a brand new month ahead of us on April 1st here, so welcome. About 9 o'clock Eastern time, you should have received an email as long as a push notification letting you know to log in to the Plan Confidence software, either through the website or the app to take a look at the new recommendations. We always update the future contributions, the money that's going to go into your 401k or your 403b plan with your next paycheck. We look at those on a monthly basis because we're trying to take advantage of some volatility and trying to buy more shares of things that are losing favor, losing momentum. So three categories we're looking at this month. Long government, same as last month. We want to take advantage of the rising interest rates on the long side, as well as small cap growth in technology. There's been volatility there, so we're hoping to capture some more shares with the increased volatility there. Also, if you're using our semi-tactical models, there are no changes. We rebalance those at the beginning of March or so. So just kind of sit tight on that. You know, those are looked at a daily basis to decide how much exposure we should have on the equity side. And if you're using our strategic models, you would receive quarterly rebalance instructions based off of what we see in front of us here. And just a few talking points too. So we're getting you back to the risk level that you were when we originally started the quarter, you know, by doing the rebalance. And we've also made a few internal changes too. So we've got more of a skew towards a blended value versus growth, you know, so we're making the whole overall portfolio a little bit more defensive, a little bit more conservative as we expect more volatility going into the next quarter. We moved out of the mid cap category and put the money into the small cap category. We reduced exposure to the emerging markets and increased exposure to large growth and foreign large blend. So again, we're taking some of the risk off the table in the international categories. We're also recommending a reduction in the technology. The NASDAQ cycle has been very volatile for the past, you know, 3 months or so. And we're moving some of that money that we reduced exposure into that into the health category, which we've never recommended in the past, but we're trying to take advantage of some hopefully regulatory changes that might be coming up in the health sector to allow us to get more exposure is there. We've also eliminated all exposure to short-term bonds and put the exposure into long-term bonds. Now, a lot of 401k plans don't even have exposure to short-term or long-term, so you're probably just sticking with intermediate-term bonds, so that may or may not actually change when you log in to look at the recommendations. And then we dramatically reduced our exposure to the world allocation, which is more of stocks and bonds in that. So log in to your account to look at the exact recommendations. As I said, they've been put out at 9 o'clock Eastern time this morning. Log in either through the app or through the software platform, through any web browser. Take a look at the allocations on there. But I just want to make sure that you had a better understanding of exactly why you're doing the rebalance and some of the internal changes that we made as we continue to provide advice for you and your loved ones and family. In regards to any money that you're currently investing with your employer. So with that, I will see you next month when we let you know how we're changing the future contributions on there. If you have any questions, don't be shy. Otherwise, I hope you guys make it an awesome, awesome, awesome month of April. And this is your cousin Kevin saying peace. God bless.